Hello, welcome back to the workshop. In the workshop this time. Right, so I need to make something to do the same job this does. What this is, you use a pair of these on the shaft of the bench grinder to hold disky things in. So what I've done, firstly, is I've sketched down some drawing of said piece after a fashion. Not a particularly good drawing. And what we're going to do is we are going to go and make something starting off like this. Then we can chamfer off those corners afterwards. But that will then give us the ability to hold this and face off this end. And then create this here. Because I mean, we don't want all of this here. You need a certain amount of cuppiness to it. So what we've got in the chuck here is a bit of 3-inch thick bar. It's bar in stock, it's not particularly pleasant stuff. And what we're going to do initially is just cut into it and take it down to the correct outside dimension, down to there, give me an inch, and then I should be able to part off a couple of lumps. Then I'm going to go and create the faces I want on this side for the outside, cut it off with a hacksaw, then do it again, and then we'll make the inside bit. But you don't need to see all of that, but what I'll do is just show you the bottom bits. Right, let's turn this light on. Let's machine. See now, why is that rubbing the wrong way? It could be that I'm not taking enough off. Let me think. Don't like the sound of that much. Could change the tip. I tell you what, I might just change the tip back. Just unless it's the angle. bit hit and miss trying to find the right cutting speeds when you're using inserts. Let's try a lower cutting speed. I'm a bit flummoxed to that. Okay, the only thing I can think of is that it needs a much more aggressive cut, so that's what we're going to try. Let me try going in from here, 20 thou. To face it off, so it can't be that bad. Let me think. Producing a very bad finish, that's definitely all wrong. Okay, let's try that instead of doing it like that. It's not great, but it'll do. Okay, it's important to, you couldn't do this without that centering. And I think we might just be, because otherwise it would pop straight out. So where are we? Right, so we're going to go in, coming about 4 but too long. Sort of chippings you'd usually after, and like that, nice and short. Right. Okay, so we want not that much more left, 2.3. Right, so we just want another 30 thou off. I made a mistake there. I'm now 20 thou undersized. Right, well, never mind. Okay, so now cut the step into it. I want the step to be, I haven't got a number for that. just check something here. That's 1/8, 194. That was 325, that's 3/8, so we want 2/8. Let's wind this all the way back this way. And what we want to do is go in 250. We start there. In another 40,000, 0. So we want to go in 250 thou. That gear off. Stupid boy. Right. Back out to 0 somewhere. We have a problem here. Go in more. Right. Okay, I need to lock the carriage to do that, because otherwise I'm just forcing the carriage away. So let me get the carriage lock out.
Thank you.
confident that we're going to get another six thou. So we will. Right. Right, I'm going to go and have a tea break, and then we're going to come back and hit it with a parting off bar. But this is going to get hacksawed off after it's had a mark put in with a parting off tool, because this is difficult stuff to part. And then we'll take it from there. Right, we're now at parting off. This is going to be difficult. That's parting off blade is not going to go all the way through. I've squared that up so that blade is going straight through square. I've lined up that face with that face and then come back this way quarter of an inch. And I've come back quarter of an inch because that will give me plenty of meat, because I'm going to end up hacksawing this off and then I'm going to have to clean it up. The other thing I've done is I've double checked that this is pushing tight in that way. These operations are only safe because there's a centre there. If I did this without the centre there, this would have come out of the chuck and hurt someone, or rather hurt me and the chuck and everything else. Right, so let's go. Right, that's as far as it goes. So that's full power. Right, that's as far as that can go in, I think. Well, that's as far as I'm going to take it in. Alright. I'm going to get the hacksaw out. Hacksaw it off. Back in a minute. Right, next stage. We have two blanks made. I managed to make those two slightly different sizes. And they were parted off best I can. That needs to be... The next operation, which we'll do two of, because we've got two of these, is going to be cleaning this face off and then cutting this down to 1/8 thick. So we've swapped the jaws over, and because it wants to end up being a hole in it, I'm going to drill the hole now, because that will make other operations a bit easier. Just make sure that's all the way in. It is. Let's get the tailstock reasonably close. I cinched down. I must get myself an open-ended one of these for this machine. Right. Just draw a hole. We get it to the right size in a minute. It's actually quite a large. Hold on. I'm going to have to move that out. Really do with a quick change tool post, but I now have some steel to make one, so that will be something I'll do. 212 thou. So we want to come in by, for 125 we want to come in 125 we want to come in 75 87. So let's go in from here, go in 40 thou. That's quite a deep cut, it's 1 millimetre roughly. So that was 40, so we should be down to, actually it was about 42, so we'll be down to 167, right, okay, so we want 42 thou from there. So I've miscalculated. That's that. Right. Okay, that's 129 thou. That can't be right. Let me just try that again. Okay. Let's a little bit thicker than I wanted. Only 4 thou, that'll do. Right, so now what we want to do is go in and start pulling that out, but I'm going to draw that up to final size first. So just get that out of the way. Okay, so now what I need to do is just get set that up so I can pull this out a little bit, which I just need to work out. So we'll be back in a minute. Right, so now we're just going to go and put some relief in the face. We're not using the best tool for the job, but we only want to do a little bit of relief. Here in the that off. Can't get a boring bar in there primarily because I haven't got the boring bar up to the right height. But I don't think I need to do any more relief than that. So that will do for that job. What we now want to do is do the next one. Might as well do with that in there. Thank you. and see how that fits. Then we're going to turn that round and do the outside. Yeah, I might come back when I've got the boring bar sorted out and put that out a bit more. Doesn't quite go on. Let me just check. And we are going to have to read that out. That half inch drill didn't take it out half inch. Right. Let's get the reamer out. Is too stiff on the shaft. So it'll be fine once we engage. Just okay. So let's knock this in a little bit harder. That is perfect. Right, okay. Right, so we have this set up back in the reverse jaws, and we're just going to compound slide over at 45 degrees. So we can just come in and cut like that. And what we are going to do is just put a chamfer on there. When I say chamfer, I mean we are going to go and curl that about 45 degrees. One done, finished. Let's do the next one. Number two done. So there we go. Just going to stick that on. Grab the grinder. Here we have the grinder. Just pop that up like that for a sec. You see that? You can. So, pop the bushes in there. Slide that on there. On goes the cap. This is a nice fit. And up it goes. Let me just get a 19mm spanner on the top side. And there it is, all done. Thank you for watching. Please like, share and subscribe, really handy. And yes, thank you for watching.